This is easier for me to deal with these problems. I'm a sick man myself. Do you know that I just came from the hospital? I wasn't really sick. I looked a lot like this man. Yeah. But the truth of the matter is, at that time, I was feeling really pretty bad shape. So I asked my friends to take me over to the hospital. I didn't know what was bothering me. Thank God, nothing. It was turned out to be nothing, but I got scared. So I went into the hospital, and I couldn't believe it. I felt so nauseous. I was dying to see somebody to talk to about why I'm so nauseous. So a yenta, some nurse comes over to me, and she says, "Fill this out." I said, "But I feel like I'm dying." She said, "You feel like you're dying, or you know that you're dying?" I said, "I feel like I'm dying." "Then you got time to fill this out." And you would think you have to fill out these applications, because I figured it's urgent about exactly what's wrong with me. It has nothing to do with what's wrong with me. They're just general applications, questions about absolutely nothing. Nothing. "What is your mother's maiden name?" I'm not making this up. That application actually has this question. "You're bleeding to death, or you're passing away from misery. First, they must know your mother's maiden name." You believe this? "What is your mother's..." You can become a president of a country, you could join the FBI, you could do anything you want without knowing your mother's maiden name. Nobody ever asked you. Where did you ever go for any job where they said to you, "You can't work here unless you're your mother's maiden name"? But if you're passing away from human misery, what is your mother's... I know a guy didn't know his mother's maiden name. They threw him out there, wouldn't they? You know, the next question they ask you, and these, "Do you ever see these applications?" Somebody might think I made it up. This is a simple fact. You know what they ask you? They ask you your the color of your eyes, as if they can't treat you unless you have the right color. And then they ask you your height. Do you know that every application includes, "What is your height?" Now, let me ask you a question. Who passed away from too much height? When is the last time a doctor said to you, "In order for me to treat you, I have to know your height"? You ever hear a guy said, "I got very sick"? "Why?" "I didn't take care of my height." They said, "It's a shame he died at such a young age." "Why?" "He didn't know nothing about his height." Did you ever notice another thing, that you can't get out of a hospital today without an enema? Because hospitals are on insurance systems and they get paid for treatments, so whether you need it or not, they give you tests and treatments and rays and different kinds of tchotchkes that you serve no purpose whatsoever, that you really don't need. You cannot get out of a hospital now without having an enema. Right away, within 10 minutes, some nurse will come over to you, "It's time for an enema." "What are you here for?" "I came to visit my sister-in-law." Did you ever notice another thing, that now all the doctors in all the hospitals are Indians? Have you ever noticed that? 90% of the doctors in all the hospitals are now Indians. I never could figure that out. Every time you take a taxi, who's the driver? An Indian. There's always an Indian driving every taxi. An hour later, he's a doctor. And Jews are just the opposite. Every time you see a Jew, he's a doctor. But in the hospital, it's just the opposite. Every patient is a Jew, and every doctor is an Indian. I keep wondering, what happened to all the Jewish doctors? Where are they? I found out, they're an Indian. And these Indian doctors don't care if you live or die. They don't care. They pick up a chart. Look at the cock and the book and the look. I see by the chart, it says here that you lock and they walk and they lock it. In order for me to help you, you have to cock and the box. Well, I cannot help you, I'll let you lock it. Now, right now, I see by the chart that it says here that you cock it, they walk and they cock and they lock it. Now this how this this is in order for me to buy the organ. This is the body only cover. You have to remember, you have to remember to take your certain pill. This pill of what I'm gonna give you, I'm gonna this pill is a surprise to you, but I got in the body. He said, do you remember that? I said, look at the coconut. This pill in the morning, you take this in the morning, the name of this pill is pocket, look at the pocket, take it, cock it, like it. Could you repeat that? Cock it, look at it. But you better not forget that, because if you forget it in the morning, look at it. I took it now in the afternoon. Is another pill, the pill you take in the afternoon, in the pocket the cocket, pocket the locket, in the morning pocket, in the morning locket, and at night time, pocket, 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 locket, pocket, pocket, the pocket. These are three pills a day, and they walk it, stick it, lock it. But I will never go lock it if you don't come pocket, lock it. And that's the last time I have to tell you, because if I'm going to leave over there in the hospital and I come back and they will look at it and I see you, and you will look at the pocket and look at the pocket, I will not be able to pocket to you because pocket to me, the pocket and look at the pocket.